गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द चैप्टर ग्लोब लैटिट्यूड एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल बी स्टडिंग अबाउट व्हाट इज ग्लोब, हाउ इट इज़ यूजफुल एंड द लैटिट्यूड्स एंड लॉन्जिट्यूड्स। यू ऑल नो द अर्थ इज नियरली अ स्फीयर। द शेप ऑफ द अर्थ इज नीदर राउंड नॉर परफेक्ट स्फीयर, बट बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स सर्फेस फ्लैट फ्लैटन्स एट द नॉर्थ पोल एंड द साउथ पोल एंड बल्जिस एट द इक्वेटर। यस, द अर्थ इज स्फेरिकल इन शेप। इट इज स्लाइटली फ्लैटन एट बोथ द पोल्स एंड बल्जिस एट द इक्वेटर। स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी इन द ग्लोब दैट एट द नॉर्थ पोल एंड द साउथ पोल द इक्वेटर इज फ्लैट, बट एट द सेंटर इट बल्जिस ड्यू टू द कॉन्ट्रीफ्यूजन और आउटवर्ड फोर्स caused by the rotation of the earth. This shape is referred as geoid. The earth is represented by spherical model of the earth. The globe is always mounted on its stand with its axis tilted. This is so because the earth's axis is also tilted at 23.5 degrees away from the perpendicular to its orbital plane. Orbital means the path on which the earth revolves round the sun. The north end of the axis is known as north pole and the south end of the axis is called as south pole. Clear students, there are two poles, north pole and south pole. The north end of the axis is called as north pole and the south end of the axis is called as south pole. Places on the earth are located by means of two sets of lines drawn on a globe or a map, that is latitude and longitude. These are imaginary lines drawn by the geographers which do not actually exist on the surface of the earth, but they are imaginary lines. Clear students? So this was about the globe. So globe is a small model of the earth which gives us the representation of the model of the earth. Now the globe has lines drawn on the surface which form a crisscross pattern. The globe has lines drawn on its surface which forms a crisscross pattern, that is called as grid. The lines cut each other at right angles. The east-west lines are called as parallels of latitudes and the north-south lines are called as meridians of longitude. The line which divides the earth into two equal halves is known as equator. The line which divides the earth into two equal halves is known as equator. This is the longest latitude and is numbered as zero latitude. Half of the earth north of the equator is called northern hemisphere and the southern half is called as the southern hemisphere. Students, you can see the world map. With the help of globe, you can see the world map showing important lines of latitudes and longitudes. Yes, along with the two basic points of reference, the North Pole and the South Pole, two sets of imaginary lines are drawn. They intersect each other at right angles on the face of the earth and form a grid. These two sets of lines are known as parallels of latitudes and the meridians of longitude. Now, the lines which run horizontally in east-west direction parallel to each other are called parallels of latitudes. The lines which are called parallels because they never meet each other and run in the same direction. They are always equal in size. They are always unequal in size. As far we move towards the poles, their length goes on decreasing. The largest parallel is the equator, which divides the earth into two equal halves. The northern half is known as the northern hemisphere and the southern half is called the southern hemisphere. Equator is also known as the great circle. The largest circle which can be drawn on a spherical body which represents the circumference of the sphere and tends to divide it into two equal parts. Lines which run vertically in north-south directions and tend to intersect each other at poles are called meridians of longitude. They meet each other at the poles and are equal in size. The distance between these intersecting lines is more near the equator and it goes on decreasing until it becomes zero at the poles. And there are the measurement. How the measurement of this is done? Both the latitudes and longitudes are measured in degrees because they represent the angular distance. Each degree is further divided into 60 minutes and each minute into 60 seconds. We can draw infinite number of latitudes and longitudes on the map, but geographers prefer to draw this interval of at 10 to 50 degree of convenience. Now we move towards the next topic, that is parallels of latitudes. The parallels of latitudes refer to the angular distance measured in north or south of the equator along the meridian. All latitudes are circles which are parallel to the equator. These are drawn in the east-west directions. And measured in degrees. There are 90 latitudes in northern hemisphere and 90 latitudes in southern hemisphere. So they are termed as in northern hemisphere northern latitudes, while in southern hemisphere southern latitudes. These are indicated with the letter N and S respectively. For example, London is 51 degree north latitude while Sydney is 33 degree south. The size of this parallel decreases as we move towards the poles. So size of these latitudes decrease as we go towards the poles because near the poles it is flat, as we already studied that the shape of this globe is flattened at both the sides of the poles and bulges at the equator. The North Pole and the South Pole are smallest latitudes, not bigger than a dot. Now, the important parallels of latitudes are 90 degree north, 0 degree equator, South Pole 90 degree south, 23.5 degree south, Tropic of Capricorn 66.5 degree south, Antarctic Circle 90 degree south, South Pole 66.5 degree north, Antarctic Circle 23.5 degree north, Tropic of Cancer. So these are the important latitudes which we need to study. Now, the different heat zones of the earth. The parallels of latitudes divides the earth into three heat zones on the basis of the amount of heat received from the sun. So these heat zones have been divided, students, according to the amount of heat they receive from the sun. And the important heat zones are torrid zone, temperate zone and the frigid zone. These are the important heat zones. Torrid zone means the heat zone because it is near the equator. You can see on both the sides of the equator there lies the torrid zone between the two tropics, that is Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. There the direct rays of sun are experienced in high temperature throughout the year. Again, the torrid zone lies between the equator and the two tropics, that is Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn, and direct rays of heat are received in high temperature throughout the year. This belt is also called as the tropical zone. The southern half of India lies in the torrid zone. It is because the Tropic of Cancer passes through the middle of India. Temperate zone. Temperate means moderate. Neither very hot, not very cold. The areas on the earth lying between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Arctic Circle in the Northern Hemisphere and the Tropic of Capricorn and the Antarctic Circle in the Southern Hemisphere are the two temperate zones. Here the sun rays are always slanting and neither too hot nor too cold. So, the region of the temperate zone is not so very hot, not so very cold. It has moderate climate, not very high cold, hot and not so cold. That is the temperate zone. The last zone is the frigid zone. Frigid means the cold region. The areas on the earth lying between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere and the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole in the Southern Hemisphere are the two frigid zones. Clear, students? The area between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere and the Antarctic Circle and the South Pole in the Southern Hemisphere are called as the two frigid zones on the Earth. The sun never rises above the horizon in these areas. The rays fall extremely slanting and do not carry much heat. These regions remain very cold throughout the year. The amount of heat reduces as we move towards the poles. So these are the students about the frigid zone.